Right, darling, we're all going to see Paula and you're going to ride tango.
Tango.
Yes. What colour is Tango?
Big
horse, isn't he?
Sarah wasn't vaccinated against measles because she'd had a touch of baby eczema. She was 5 3/4. We went to pick her up from school on the Friday afternoon, met at the school gate with her teacher, who said, "I think Sarah's going to have the measles." And I just said very complacently, "Well, if she's not in school on Monday, you'll know why." It was on the Sunday morning that the rash appeared, and we sent for the doctor for him to confirm that it was measles. And he said, "Oh my goodness, that's a marvellous case of measles, that is. But don't worry about her, she'll be okay. She'll start getting better now the rashes come out." And then, in front of our very eyes, she started slipping away. And she was in a coma before we knew where we were. Her whole body, literally her whole body was smothered with measles. So badly that it did attack her brain. She was in a coma for 8 weeks, at death's door for 8 weeks, literally.
Hello there.
Hello, Karen. Hello.
Hello, Tango.
Well, initially, Sarah was blind, completely blind. She couldn't hear at all. She didn't know anybody. She had no memory at all of having been ill. And it was just as though we'd got a different child to what we had when she went into the hospital. She's now registered partially sighted, and she's hearing impaired. She's also got what they call muscular hypertonia, which is where the muscles lose their tone completely, and that's what makes her very, very floppy. Walks like a little rag doll. Sarah doesn't like the way she is at all. She's very aware that she's different to her sister and to the people and the friends who she had before her illness. Extremely aware. She gets very upset that she's like this. She doesn't want to be like this. She invariably and intermittently asks us to give her new eyes and new ears. And when we say, "We can't do that, Sarah," she will say, "Take me to the hospital, Mum. They'll give me new eyes and new ears." Don't be blasé about it at all. You can't afford to be. Because a child who suffers brain damage, they're brain damaged for life. And that is something that is very hard to bear.